Could Xbox enter the landscape of handheld gaming? Well, recent rumors seem to indicate that they are working on a handheld, which has some Xbox fans excited and others asking why. Now, in previous streams and previous content, I actually said that I would actually rather see Xbox make an awesome handheld versus them sort of trying to do another high-end console, especially after what happened with the Series X and the Series S. So I do, though, have to sort of agree with the sentiment of, like, why would they be doing this? This doesn't seem to sort of fit with what they've been talking about. Maybe it does. Maybe it's, you know, right in line with Play Anywhere. There are, though, I think, existing handhelds that let folks engage with the Xbox ecosystem. There was a Phil Spencer interview we are going to look at, though, where he doesn't seem to think those feel like an Xbox. There's also the impending Nintendo Switch 2, and, you know, is it going to be worth Microsoft sort of doing the research, the development, the investment, the raw materials they'll have to acquire, you know, just to create a handheld? But it could be more than just a handheld, according to other rumors. We heard that maybe this was like a dockable thing. We've heard about the console cloud hybrid, the FTC leaks. You know, there were a lot of different things they were thinking about doing. Satya Nadella was like, let's just make a controller and people can access that way. So there's a lot of ways this plays out. So first, I want to walk through the history of handheld gaming devices. No, I will not be going all the way back to the very first Game Boy, but I want to look at sort of the recent development with devices like the Nintendo Switch, the Steam Deck, the Asus ROG Ally, and the like. Now, second, we do need to then look at the rumors. Like, is that why this is happening? Is there this potential of that market sort of taking off? The history of handhelds could be playing a part here. We also have comments from Phil Spencer about his newfound love for handhelds, right? And he's tried them all. Now, there's also some Microsoft patents that could be contributing to this potential hardware plan that they have in place. And then lastly, I am going to tell you what I think. There's a lot to consider here. Recent comments from gamesindustry.biz after GDC. It's just not looking very good for Xbox on the hardware front. It's not looking good on the third-party company front. Like, third-party games and developers are questioning just putting stuff on Xbox going forward, which is not surprising. Some of us kind of predicted that would start to happen. But I'm actually torn because I kind of want an Xbox handheld, but I'm also questioning the business reasons behind making one. Like, would they see good cause and good reason to do this? So let's just think about the history here of handhelds. This all started with the Nintendo Switch, and now others are going to argue differently. They're going to like, well, no, the Game Boys, all the different iterations of the Game Boy, or maybe even the Wii U. But for me, and from my perspective on actual handhelds that we're seeing in the market now, the Nintendo Switch, in my estimation, was disruptive. It created an entirely new idea, and it wasn't sold on power, it wasn't sold on graphics or performance. It was sold on an idea that people scoffed at. You know, many still remain skeptical of fact if that's worth buying or worth using, but it far exceeded everybody's expectations. Even during the FTC trial, Bobby Kotick, former Activision CEO, he indicated that they underestimated the Nintendo Switch, and he seemed at some level to even be sort of regretful about that. You know, the Switch was in 2017, and it is massively saturated the market. Now, 5 years, the Switch comes out in 2017. 5 years later, the Steam Deck is introduced. And I remember when there was talk about a Steam Deck, people were like, really? Why? Why would you make a device like that? And then the device was very much in high demand. It was very difficult to get one. Then a year later, the Asus ROG Ally. Everybody always says it differently, but that's just how I say it. That came out a year later. And then later in the same year, there was the Lenovo Legion Go. Say that five times fast, right? The Lenovo Legion Go. So it would seem that the idea of a handheld as a gaming device, I believe it's taking hold. You know, the market is supporting it. Now, I don't know if it's going to see massive growth. I don't know if the Nintendo Switch has set an expectation. I mean, if you just look in Japan alone, like one in every four people, according to their population numbers and the number of Nintendo Switches sold in Japan, like one in every four people has a Nintendo Switch. That's an insane saturation rate. And so maybe this is a way that Xbox sees they could cut into markets where handheld gaming is more prominent. The FTC leaks indicated that Microsoft was considering something that maybe could be a handheld, maybe a controller, maybe a cloud hybrid console that wouldn't be super expensive because it would be leaning on xCloud for, you know, running your games. Now, this makes the recent batch of rumors maybe easy to believe. So what are those rumors? Well, pulling from Insider Gaming, Jez Corden of the Xbox 2 podcast has claimed that Xbox is working on a native Xbox handheld. Now, there were prototypes in the past, but Jez makes sure to clarify this is not what he is speaking about. More from Insider Gaming. Quote, on the Xbox 2 podcast, Corden said, I know that they've, Xbox, have got handheld prototypes right now. He soon clarified that these are new prototypes. These are not old prototypes that have often been referred to. As pointed out in the podcast, prototypes don't necessarily mean that new products are coming to market, but Xbox pursuing a handheld is not all that surprising. That was Insider Gaming's opinion, okay? I tend to agree, okay? It's not surprising that they would be looking into it. Now, it is important, though, to remember that prototypes, they might never make it to market. We may never get a product. They may be testing this. They may scrap it. They may do their own market projections and just say, yeah, there's nothing. This won't work, okay? We can't get the price low enough. We heard that about the Keystone. There was like a dongle, like a cloud dongle, and if they couldn't get the price low enough, they just weren't going to bring it to market. Now, before anybody says, oh, this is going to be a cloud device, Jez has already shot that down. He said, no, this will not be a cloud handheld, a fully native Xbox handheld. Those are his words. This obviously has everybody's attention. Okay, well, would that be the next console? Is that what Sarah Bond was talking about? According to Insider Gaming, quote, various rumors have suggested that the console's next generation of consoles could be a dockable handheld similar to the Nintendo Switch. I've already made reference to this, right? We heard this rumor weeks ago, and I thought it could be connected to the cloud console hybrid. Maybe they've got this idea of it's an all-in-one where you can take it with you, you can dock it, it can leverage the cloud, it can install things natively, but maybe if you want better performance, you would leverage the cloud. I don't know if they're going to be able to push out 4K gaming on the cloud. Like, is that going to be one of their selling points? I've continued to say that maybe the Xbox Series S gets turned into a cloud box. This would streamline development. So if you develop a game, you sort of have to develop for the cloud, but then would you also then have to develop it for this native handheld? Now, we have to remember that Sarah Bond said this during that podcast. She said, quote, there's some exciting stuff coming out in hardware, and we're going to share this holiday. So I feel this might be related to the digital Series X that was recently leaked due to a dev kit rating in South Korea. So maybe that's where they're going to announce this holiday, a digital Series X. Don't think there's going to be super high demand for that, but it's something to announce. It's new hardware to push. But maybe they're planning to announce this handheld earlier than that, okay? Now, in the same podcast, Sarah Bond also said, what we've really focused on there is delivering the largest technical leap you will have ever seen in a hardware generation. So she's talking about the next generation of hardware that they start working on. Now, this could certainly be a big technical leap in their mind if they do some sort of a dockable handheld. According to PC Gamer, quote, Microsoft's new patent promises more efficient ray tracing for the Xbox, and that could be a real boon for AMD graphics cards. That article is not old. It sounds like, oh man, that's something Microsoft probably have done for a while. No, that was just published the same day that everybody started talking about these rumors about the Xbox handheld. Now, the article there from PC Gamer said the following. Microsoft's patent is primarily targeted towards improving ray tracing performance on its Xbox Series X consoles. The technique could be implemented on any platform, as it's not specific toward any particular hardware. Now, given that the Series S largely does not support ray tracing, it's just never really there. It's only in a handful of games, and even then, it's not really the same full suite of ray tracing that you might see in other games on other devices. So I don't know if they're trying to leverage this ray tracing technology for the S, or is it for the X, or is it just like a generic thing they're developing to help AMD tech or AMD GPUs do a better job with ray tracing? We've talked about this before with the PS5 Pro, where developers really want to leverage more ray tracing because it automates some of the lighting work, and they prefer that. It speeds things up. And so the PS5 Pro is going to accelerate ray tracing. Well, it sounds like Xbox and Microsoft are setting their sights on the same thing. Like, we need to do a better job with ray tracing because developers want to use it. Now, maybe they're developing this for the handheld, or maybe xCloud, given that the Series X's are used for the xCloud server blades. Now, Phil Spencer also had some thoughts on what a handheld might look like. He sat down with Polygon for an interview, and the article title claims the following: a handheld Xbox, Microsoft's gaming chief can't stop thinking about it. Now, according to the article, Spencer has tried the Steam Deck, the ROG Ally, and the Lenovo Legion Go, and his biggest frustration is that they don't feel like an Xbox. They lack some of his games, or maybe they don't offer cross-save. And the article claims that, according to Spencer, the Xbox hardware team led by Rohan Soans is considering, quote, different hardware form factors and things that they could go do. What should we build that will find new players, Spencer said, that will allow people to play at times when they couldn't play in the past? Now, you'll notice his emphasis there is right at the end. What can we do that'll let players play at times where they couldn't play in the past? Well, in the interview, he references he's been using his handhelds on planes and while traveling, so it's pretty easy to connect the dots here. But it starts to get confusing because pushing forward the question why, you know, why would you do this, okay? It gets even more confusing when Phil says the following. He says, I want everything that we're doing in the hardware space to be great, but if somebody chooses to play today somewhere else, I don't want them to feel like a lesser Xbox player. Now, this makes me wonder, what would the value proposition of the Xbox handheld be? Would it be power? Are you going to make it really strong? Are you going to have a 60 FPS handheld? Like, that would be what I would want to see. It's one of the main reasons I haven't really got into the handhelds, because I don't want to play games at 30 FPS. Would this, you know, Xbox handheld be offered for ecosystem synergy? According to Polygon, he wouldn't officially announce it, but he does seem to be heavily hinting at it, and this is what they had to say. Spencer wouldn't outright announce an official Xbox handheld, but he did say he sees a similar level of creativity coming to hardware that Xbox has brought to software. Now, they closed the interview by saying that the Nintendo Wii helped at the time push software innovation. So in his mind, a handheld, like, hardware innovation would then potentially push software innovation as well. So what do I think about all of this? Well, I have to admit, I'm a little torn on this subject. I would love a natively strong portable Xbox, and people are like, why? Why would you want that? Well, it would be perfect for the games that I play on Game Pass. Games like RoboQuest, Brotato, even Diablo 4. Like, if Diablo 4 was in a better spot, that's perfect for a handheld. That's perfect when you're sort of on the go. Now, obviously, that would require Wi-Fi, but when I'm traveling and I'm at my brother's house, or I'm at the beach, or I'm going to visit family in Florida, or I'm flying, there's usually pretty good Wi-Fi available. Not necessarily maybe for cloud gaming, but for a game that requires you to be online. And even still, there's games, like I said, like RoboQuest, Brotato, even a game like Ori. Both of the Oris would be just fantastic replays on a portable device. There's also other games sort of in that vein I just never really have time for, and that's the great time to, you know, check out those indie titles or those lesser known titles that are hanging out on Game Pass. Now, somebody asked me in a members only stream, well, why would you buy this? Well, they said, how often are you using your PlayStation Portal when you're traveling? Now, the PlayStation Portal is limited because it needs really good Wi-Fi, and it has been great. It's a very useful accessory. Within my home, when I stream with my wife, she can play on a PlayStation right here on the screen, and then I can play on the other PlayStation but still be next to her. I'm just playing on the portable. It's great when I'm on the couch with the kiddos and both TVs are taken, but I still want to play with them, or I want to play a game on my own. It was solid when I had good hotel Wi-Fi, or when I was at my brother's house, but if I'm traveling, if I'm flying especially, or driving in a car, and, you know, we're taking turns driving, it would be great to have a native Xbox handheld. It'd be great to have a native PlayStation, something that would run the games. Now, again, I would like them to run the games well. I'm not interested in playing games at 30 FPS on a handheld. If I was interested in that, I would just be playing Zelda on the Switch or something like that. Now, I will say this, though. The big AAA cinematic, or like narrative-driven experiences, those are probably best experienced on my big TV and on my couch. But you've got Game Pass games that are shorter, or they're just a little bit more casual in the way that they're designed, like a RoboQuest or a Brotato. And I've got a backwards compatible catalog. You know, I've got all these Xbox titles. That would be perfect to play those on a handheld. Now, I will say that I would need that strong native performance, because, as I've said, I would not want to play games at 30. And if that takes longer to come to market, so be it. If Xbox pushes out a handheld and it largely runs games at 30, I would sit that one out. I wouldn't see the reason to buy it. It's why I didn't get a Steam Deck, because most of the games I would play on it, I wasn't going to get the best performance, or I wasn't going to get the performance that I would want. I know the Steam Deck is a great device and it's popular, but it just wasn't going to suit my needs. Now, if that's what ends up pulling me over to an Xbox handheld, I would certainly do it if they were able to hit those thresholds. But despite what I would want or what I would respond to, many are asking, like, why would Xbox do this? Who is this for? While I think it has more potential than another attempt at a high-end console, I actually think, like, if they're choosing between the two, a handheld has more potential. I think there's more opportunities for growth in that market. The console market has very much settled, and it's not going their way. So I think that's a smart move to, like, let's pivot in the cloud, let's pivot into a handheld. But you have to consider something. The Switch 2 is on the horizon. The Steam Deck and other handhelds already let folks engage with the Xbox ecosystem. So who would this device be for? Now, if it's dockable like the Switch, and maybe it's part of this console cloud hybrid that we've heard about, I could see that making more sense than just sort of a standalone native handheld. It would be part of a larger experience. They're essentially telling you every screen's an Xbox. You can take your screen with you. You can play it on your TV screen. You know, you've got this dockable thing. You can take that with you as well, and you can plug it in, or you can just play on the cloud. Now, this could also be related to cloud streaming licensing. The PlayStation Portal gets around the need for every individual game's TOS to allow for cloud streaming. You might not be aware of this, but that's why a lot of games are not available on cloud, because the publishers are making cloud streaming very expensive because they want to cut. So if a third-party game that's not owned by Xbox, if they're like, no, cloud streaming's not available in our TOS unless you pay us a significant amount of money or whatever, that might be why the games that you own are not available on cloud streaming. There's a lot of licensure problems going on right now. But let's say you had a handheld that you could install the games natively. Well, that's not cloud streaming. Or maybe it could feature remote play. Like, maybe you don't want to install the games natively, but maybe you just want to remote play to your Xbox. Well, that's how the PlayStation Portal works. That kind of gets around those, you know, red tape license issues. So it could offer both native installed games, but maybe remote play as well. And again, maybe cloud. But Xbox hardware and Xbox as a platform is not in the greatest spot, according to GameIndustry.biz. In a recent podcast after the GDC, Chris Drings shared some information that Xbox fans are not finding much comfort in. Apparently, a major company who released a big game last year basically said, I don't know why we bother supporting Xbox. Chris felt, after the GDC, that Xbox is in real trouble as a hardware manufacturer because they're flatlining in Europe. You're seeing sales decline virtually across every month. They're just not getting any saturation. They're going to fall below Xbox One saturation at this point. And there's also other feedback from third-party developers and indie studios about that just isn't worth putting games over there. The podcast also touched on how third-party publishers were actually having to put a lot of work to get the games on the Series S version and a Series X version, but then they basically said the real market where we make our money, where we make the vast majority of our sales, is on the PC and the PlayStation 5. In other words, they were spending more time and money developing for Xbox where they make the least amount of their money. Okay, that's not a business equation that companies are going to keep signing up for. So people tried to hand wave this when we talked about this in the past and accused me of hate. These are just business realities that if you don't have the footprint, if you don't have the consumer base, and your platform requires more work, that's a really, really hard pill for developers to swallow. They're spending more money on the platform where they make the least. So a lot of the Xbox news and the developments and the decline in hardware sales, it's not just affecting the consumer perspective. This is having an effect on what the developers and the publishers think as well. So how would a handheld help given the current circumstances? Maybe market research is pointing to a growing demand for gaming console handhelds, and Microsoft wants to be a part of that. If the Surface team is helping, and the recent patents help with the performance on this mobile handheld device, I could see it giving Microsoft a road into a potential growing market. But I could also see them saying, look, let's just publish within that growing market and not take on the cost and the risk, because usually items like this are a loss lead. They're expensive to make. You know, the demand is always not that strong, so you're not making a ton of them. You're not selling a ton of them. They might decide that it's just not worth it. Remember, these were just prototypes. No matter how you shake it, I think it's clear the next piece of Xbox hardware is not going to be what anybody expected a few years ago. But that's just my take. What's your take?